Hello, everyone. I hope that you're having a great day, as it is a great day for another episode of Madman Review. This is Andrew, and the topic for today is budget air guns. By budget, I mean not much higher than $400, maybe $50 more for some wiggle room. There are a number of very solid options, even at this price range. If you're new to the airgun game, allow me to give you a quick refresher. You see, every airgun has different features and operations. In this case, a brake barrel airgun utilizes a spring to compress the chamber. The barrel has a hinge that allows you to break the barrel by slapping it down. You can load the pellet, smack the barrel back into place, which would compress the chamber, and you're ready to fire. Think of it as a brake action shotgun, except the pivot point is way down the barrel, usually after the foregrip. In terms of performance, brake barrel air guns work just as well as their PCP counterparts. Sure, the pivot points might cause some concerns about accuracy, but clever engineering stops that from happening. With the theory crafting out of the way, let's talk about the fun stuff. I have here my top 5 recommendations for brake barrel air guns. They won't be the best in the market, but they provide the most value at their price points. As usual, the links to these products are in the description below, so make sure to check it out. The B-Man R9. The first on our list is the B-Man R9. Many people agree that this is probably the best brake barrel rifle you can get at this price point. It delivers amazing accuracy. The trigger feels superb, and the finish is just gorgeous. There's little not to like about this thing other than the stock scope has no mil dots and the automatic safety. Given how much the R9 brings to the table, I'm willing to forgive B-Man for that. In terms of pricing, this one is going to stretch your budget out a bit. It goes for a little under $450 by a cent if you follow the link. Actually, the reason why I defined a budget brake barrel rifle around the $450 mark is to specifically accommodate this rifle. But I guarantee that you will love this thing. You have the option of caliber, including 177, 20, and 22. It sits at 43 inches long and weighs 7.3 pounds. The spring piston can push pellets out of the rifled barrel at up to 935 feet per second. As mentioned before, you get a scope with your purchase, but you should replace it with a better one as soon as possible. There aren't many bad things to say about the stock scope other than the lack of mil dots, so you can stick with it until you can save up for a better scope. For that, you get an 11mm dovetail rail to work with. You also get a rubber butt plate for a more comfortable shooting experience. This gun is best used for small game hunting or target practice, and a lot of people really love the R9. Give it a shot, you won't regret it. Walther Paris. The Walther Paris is a German-engineered air rifle, so you already know what to expect. It is reliable, accurate, and powerful. It's available in 177 and 22, and it can deliver pellets at 1,300 feet per second and 1,000 feet per second, respectfully. The gun weighs 9.3 pounds and sits at 48 inches long. Now, the notable features include an 11mm dovetail rail at the top to mount optics, automatic safety, easily adjusted fiber optic sights, and a rifled barrel for added accuracy. The gun is built on a synthetic stock with an ergonomic design in mind for maximum comfort. In fact, it's ambidextrous. The grip texture ensures that your hand stays on the gun regardless of the weather, and the rubber recoil pad reduces the amount of kick you feel when you pull the trigger. In terms of weight, the gun might feel a bit heavy, but this is intentional. You want the gun to weigh just right due to the force required to cock it. It is also a bit loud compared to other guns on the list, and you will hear it if you use light pellets. Overall, this is an excellent value-packed air gun. It's German. What do you expect? It's consistent and durable, so you don't have to worry about any part disintegrating when you are out plinking or hunting small game. The Diana 34 EMS. The 34 EMS is also a notable budget air rifle. It is accurate, very easy to use, and it does not suffer from barrel droop that plagues other air guns. Barrel droops may be caused by wear and tear, faulty barrel, the build quality, or that the barrel is mounted incorrectly. The 34 EMS did everything right in this department, so you can breathe a sigh of relief. There are two variants, both in stock and caliber. For stock, you can get it in synthetic or beech, with the latter costing you about $15 more, but you get that beautiful wooden stock and finish. For the caliber, it's either 177 or 22, which should cover pretty much every application you can think of. This single-shot air rifle can deliver pellets through the 19.5-inch rifle barrel at up to 1,050 feet per second or 950 feet per second for 177 and 22, respectfully. The overall length is 45.5 inches, and the gun weighs 7.4 pounds. You got your automatic safety system and the basic 11mm dovetail rail to mount your optics. The two-stage adjustable trigger feels excellent since it's a T06 trigger. This rifle is best used for small game hunting and plinking. At its price point, it is one of the most value-packed options out there in terms of price to performance. Hatson Model 125. The Model 125 from Hatson comes in 177, 22, and 25 and delivers a muzzle velocity at 1,250, 1,000, and 750 feet per second, respectively. The gun weighs a measly 9 pounds and is about 49 inches long. A notable feature about this thing is that it delivers a lot of power without the vibration and twang found in other guns with coiled metal springs. Other than that, you get an 11mm rail for your optics, a built-in muzzle brake suppressor, anti-bear trap mechanism, twin raised cheek pieces, and an adjustable comb, texture for the pistol grip and the forearm for the outdoor, and the shock absorber system to reduce vibration and felt recoil. The two-stage adjustable trigger feels light and crisp. It is available in synthetic stock and is built to withstand the harsh outdoor environment. For this reason, you should use this gun to hunt small game other than for target practice. The Sig Sauer ASP-20. Finally, we have the ASP-20. It's powerful, it's consistent, and most importantly, it's from Sig Sauer. So you can bet that quality would be excellent. Though it must be said for this is that their first product in the break barrel market, and yet their experience and expertise really show, even though they are new to the game. The ASP-20 is a 177 caliber single-shot break barrel rifle capable of spitting out lead at 1,021 feet per second. The gun weighs about 8.5 pounds, and the overall gun length is 45.6 inches. You get a Weaver Picatinny rail at the top for optics, manual safety, and I appreciate a two-stage adjustable trigger that feels excellent, and a rifle barrel for enhanced accuracy. All of that is integrated into a sleek black synthetic stock. You can also get in a wooden stock if you're willing to shell out around $80 for it. It is ideal for small game hunting and target practice. Sig Sauer really knocked it out of the park with the ASP-20 by delivering a gun at a competitive price compared to Diana, Walther, and Wyrak. The ASP-20 offers an excellent value given its price point and performance. And there you have it. Everyone, of course, these guns are best at their price points, but there are plenty more that are better if you're willing to splurge just a bit more. Usually there's better options if you spend $50 to $100 more, but then there is something that is always a little better if you're willing to spend a little bit more. As the old saying goes, buy once, cry once. But if you have to put your feet down and say that you're sticking to my price point, then the above guns will not fail you. Thank you for watching. If you have any other recommendations that you think are worth making the list, let us know down in the comment section below. Make sure to give us a like if you've enjoyed this video and subscribe for more content like this. Have fun and see you next time.